Joining us now to talk about the planets aligning is the professor of astrophysics at the University of Rochester, Adam Frank. Adam, I mean, I love that Smithsonian described this as a parade in the western sky. What are we going to see? How cool is this going to be?
Well, basically, you're going to be able to see the architecture of the solar system. You're going to see the fact that all the planets all orbit around the sun in a giant pancake. And so that lineup that you're going to see on the western sky right after sunset is the fact that all the planets right now are in a position on that pancake that they're all going to basically line up. So you'll have Mercury, Jupiter, and then Venus. Uranus is going to be a little hard to see without a binoculars, and then Mars as well. So, you know, you're going to really see where we live.
Yeah. Listen, you know, there's an old saying that, my goodness, the planets were aligned and it means something big and great and good. What does this mean? I know it doesn't happen very often. How often does it happen? And what is the enormity of this, sir?
The enormity is like coolness, basically. Like, you know, from a cosmic perspective, these things aren't really that rare. Getting some of the planet, because they are, all the planets are, we all orbit in a one giant frisbee. So it's not uncommon to get some of the planets to align. This one, because you're getting so many of them aligning, is a little bit more rare. But it's more just to see where we are. I mean, it's, you know, what's amazing is we've lost the night sky. The sky is so bright now with lights that we don't get to see the planets. But our ancestors, even 200 years ago, they noticed that the planets were moving around against the fixed stars, and it freaked them out, and it was a show. And so for us to be able to be reminded that we live in a solar system, that we live on a rock that's hurling with a bunch of other rocks around this giant flaming ball, is a really powerful reminder of just how profoundly beautiful and mysterious the world is.
Well, Adam, given that, quickly, what is the easiest way to see it tonight? What, you just walk outside, or is there like a certain place you should go? What is the easiest way to see it when this happens?
You want to go someplace right after sunset where you get a good view of the western sky, because Venus and Mercury are going to be pretty close to the horizon, and they're going to set pretty close. Jupiter and Mercury. Venus will be higher in the sky, so you'll be able to see it for longer. Then eventually Mars and the moon, you'll be able to see those as well. But you want a clear view of the western sky. If you have binoculars, then you'll probably also be able to make out Uranus as well.
And some place where there's not a lot of light pollution, someplace that's, you know, where it gets dark and you don't
the
have
better, it. Yeah, the yeah. darker the skies, the better the show.
All right.
Adam Frank.
Thank you so much, Adam.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Stars were aligned for this interview.
I love it. What's the significance of that, he said? Planets basically, just because it's cool.
Yeah, because it's cool.